Yes, the Honda Civic is back in the Indian market. And in its 10th generation, it's larger and much more sportier looking, undoubtedly, than the earlier model. And this time around, it's got both petrol and diesel engines. The question is though, will Honda's new Civic give its competitors, namely the Toyota Corolla Altis, Hyundai's Elantra, and the Skoda Octavia, sleepless nights? Now to answer that question, we have four things that work for the Honda's new Civic, and two that don't. Well, we don't usually talk about looks, but you have to admit that the Civic is just a looker. I mean, look at those curves.
That brutal swooping roofline is complemented by a low slung profile with edgy body lines and aggressively etched headlamps and tail lamps.
And if that weren't enough, the minimal overhangs and that wide stance just nails it. I've got goosebumps already.
Now the new Honda Civic gets two engine options. A 1.8-litre petrol engine with a CVT gearbox and a 1.6-litre diesel engine with a 6-speed manual gearbox like we have here. Performance in the diesel is more than adequate and there's a fairly strong tug when you get on the move, which is then followed by a linear power delivery. The icing on the cake though is the slick shifting 6-speed manual transmission with closely stacked gates and a short gear lever. It's just a joy to use on the go. But what's surprising about this diesel engine is the refinement, which when combined with the superior cabin insulation, just makes for a calm and serene drive. The Civic just shines when it comes to ride quality. It remains plush over broken surfaces at all speeds, and it doesn't even get harsh at the limit. Besides that, there's hardly any suspension noise, and importantly, unlike the earlier car, it's got adequate ground clearance too. On the handling front, the tight road manners are courtesy, the excellent chassis balance, and the brilliant suspension setup. Also, the light and quick steering offers an accurate response, which is further aided by very few turns from lock to lock. And this makes it easy to maneuver within city limits. Now, the rear bench in the Honda Civic is extremely comfy, but it's optimum for two passengers. So, accommodating a third passenger will push the others to the ends where the sloping roofline will constantly brush their heads.
So what we have here right now is the 1.8-litre petrol motor with a CVT gearbox. And just like any other motor from Honda, this one is smooth and refined. And it's got more than enough grunt for most city driving situations.
But it's the CVT gearbox's prominent rubber band effect that spoils the show, as the revs take too long to build, especially when you mash the throttle for an overtake. And sadly, even the paddle shifts can't really help speed things up, as you'd imagine.
The new Honda Civic has a lot going for it. The engines are refined, it's dynamically sorted, and the cabin is not only comfy, it's silent too. All the right ingredients, you'd say, for being both the city commuter and the mile muncher. Quite the all-rounder, you'd say.